I know a lot of young horses, you'll see they'll run all over the pen. You can't catch them. First of all, most of them are not rode down enough. I still say you need to ride these horses down, get them a little tired, so they're finding a resting spot. We want that resting spot to be in the corner of the pen, the far end corner of the pen from the chute. So he's going in at the left corner. We want him always to go to that left corner. We don't ever want a horse cutting us off or going across that steer. So we're always going to the left corner, okay? That's it, very important. Also, if you can see this, and you will, there's some feed on a bucket, just on a 55-gallon drum, just like we did over on the jumping dummy, and I'm relating this that way because you want that horse to get to related as well. All right, so he'll find that feed, and he'll find where he's supposed to be, and that's his resting spot, okay? So what I like to do is I'll start a horse off, and they've got to find, what I say, they've got to find themselves in that corner. They got to be able to run into the corner. We don't want them to slow down. We want them fast. We want them going, running all the way through the cattle. No matter where they are in that pen, if it's halfway, three quarters way, you'll see a lot of horses, they run well up at the front of the box, but they don't run very well when they get toward the end of the pen. And that's something that you have to create that environment for the horse. So here's what I like to do there. I'll take this David Buckin, he's riding my Hayes horse, but for practical purposes, we're just gonna show this, and I wanna show him. Now he's gonna ride this horse, and I start off, come around, David. I'm gonna have him come around me, just walk the horse. Now when you're starting a young horse, again, you want that horse to be calm, collective, and you know, this horse is like 18 years old, so I mean, he's been around a while, all right? You see him go to that feed, he's gonna walk him to that feed, let him get a bite or two of that feed. This is a first for him, and I just wanted to show this like we're starting a young horse. He's not a bulldogging horse, all right? Turn him around, David, and bring him up. Come on around, now trot. So you saw how, well, you might want to walk him 10 times around there until he relaxes, and then trot. Now come on around, about a half circle there. Now you just kind of, when he releases those reins, this horse may, he may speed up a little. Let's release the reins. He may speed up a little bit. He's going to go to the corner. He'll find his feed, stop right there. Now look, stay right there, David. And I want to make a point here. I said something about being patient. Right here is where you're patient. Let that horse relax a little bit right there in that corner. Don't make this just somewhere else for him to go. Make it, let him relax in that corner. This is where you're gonna pick him up. That's where the Hayes horse is gonna pick him up. If he gets used to going to that corner, and that's a stopping place for him and a resting place, he'll be there from now on. If you never teach him this, then you got a horse that runs all over the pen. And he never gets better. Now there's horses that are amped up, and I know they take off and they do certain things, but he needs to know this, that there is a resting place for him. Okay, now just do this again. Go ahead, David. I want you to lope that circle. Hey, when you get right about here, I'll tell you when. Go ahead and lope him. All right. Now release him. Totally release the horse. Let him go. There you go. See how he ran up in the corner? You see how he stops? Right there is a good example of what I want to see a bulldogging horse do. I don't want him stopping out here. I don't want him having to create something out here. I want him to stop at the gate. I do want him to stop. I've seen horses, bulldogging horses, that are amped up, run right through the back gate of, if they hadn't been trained. Now, when he sees this stopping point, I want him getting in the ground. I want him to slide in there. I don't want him to run up here and start checking off right here or ducking left and right. If he knows that corner's there, you saw how he just ran in there, David, and kind of slid in there? That's what you want to feel. He was in one motion, one slide, he's good. He's not gonna hurt himself. He gets on that back hock, he's not gonna hurt himself. Let him stop, get him some grain. The longer you sit there, it's a win-win, okay? If you're sitting there, that's a good thing. You may have to sit there 15 minutes to let him calm down. But if you do that, and you do that, and look, I'm not just doing this for the horses. That's not what this is just about. You start feeling that horse on you. If you're riding, and David, you've never ridden this horse in the corner. That felt pretty good, didn't it? But if you were riding him, you'd be confident if you ran him in there, this horse is running wide open, that he's gonna stop in this corner where he's supposed to, okay? It gives you confidence on the horse. Also, if you're a young steer wrestler, the scariest thing to a lot of young steer wrestlers, they don't tell us this, But it's the fact that if they don't get off, what's going to happen at the end? They're afraid they're going to hit the gate, they're going to hurt themselves. They don't know how to feel that horse in a stop. They've never ridden a horse wide open and just had him run up in a corner and stop. Good bulldogging horses that run to the corner, they're going to be a little scary to start with. They're going to make you think when you get to the end of the pen. And the worst thing you can do is try to rein them. You know, just kind of sit there, get you a deep seat in the saddle. I've also had young people that were maybe a little overweight or they hadn't ridden real well a long time. I'll tell them, say, don't worry about the saddle. You got the reins in your hand, reach back, grab the back of the saddle, and you're locked in. You can brace yourself all day long. No way to throw you out of the saddle. So that's another good way if you got a young person to keep him safe until he feels confident and all that. After a while, he'll forget about it. But that's a good way to do that, and I think if you'll do that, you'll have confidence, your horse will have confidence. Good way to start a young horse. Also, it teaches him, hey, I've got control. I want him in variable speeds. You know, you want this horse to run through cattle, but you want him in variable speeds. You want to be able to control him. And a good bulldogging horse, I mean, he should ride like an old cow horse, and then he should do his job after that. So that's about all I got to say about this. But I think this will help a lot of horses. And even if you got an old horse that runs all over the pen, try this on him. You know, walk him, trot him, lope him, let him find that end, let him find that corner, and that might stop him, and it might, that little bit of feed, a little bit of time, it might make him a whole lot more pleasurable when you take him to the rodeos and they're calling the next guy's name.